You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words to foreign people, and they will understand. You shall see the face of God.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
A hearty welcome to the Eucharist, my dear sisters and brothers, on this, the 15th of July, the Feast of Saint Bonaventure. So we have wearing white, Doctor of the Church. They call him the second founder of the Franciscan Order. A seraphic doctor, a great theologian, great mystic. Let's begin the sacrifice, putting ourselves in God's presence, preparing ourselves to receive His word by saying, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have grievously sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, to my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that just as we celebrate the heavenly birthday of the Bishop Saint Bonaventure, we may benefit from his great learning and constantly imitate the ardor of his charity. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Kindly sit.
A reading from the book of Exodus. In those days, hearing the voice of the Lord out of the midst of the bush, then Moses said to God, "If I come to the people of Israel and say to them, 'The God of your father has sent me to you,' and they ask me, 'What is his name?' what shall I say to them?" God said to Moses, "I am who I am." And he said, "Say this to the people of Israel, 'I am has sent me to you.'" God also said to Moses, "Say this to the people of Israel, 'The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever. And thus I am to be remembered throughout all generations. Go and gather the elders of Israel together and say to them, 'The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, of Isaac, and of Jacob, has appeared to me, saying, I have observed you and what has been done to you in Egypt, and I promise that I will bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt to the land of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, the Hivites, and the Jebusites, a land flowing with milk and honey. And they will listen to your voice, and you and the elders of Israel shall go to the king of Egypt and say to him, 'The Lord, the God of the Hebrews, has met with us. And now, please let us go a 3 days' journey into the wilderness, that we may sacrifice to the Lord our God.' But I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go, unless compelled by a mighty hand. So I will stretch out my hand and strike Egypt with all the wonder that I will do in it. After that, he will let you go." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, "The Lord remembers his covenant forever." Altogether, "The Lord remembers his covenant forever." Give thanks to the Lord, proclaim his name, make known his deeds among the peoples. Remember the wonders he has done, his marvel and his words of judgment. Our response, "The Lord remembers his covenant forever." He remembers his covenant forever, the promise he ordained for 1,000 generations, the covenant he made with Abraham, the oath he swore to Isaac. Our response, "The Lord remembers his covenant forever." He gave his people great increase. He made them stronger than their foes, whose heart he turned to hate his people and to deal deceitfully with his servants. Our response, "The Lord remembers his covenant forever." Then he sent Moses' servant and Aaron, whom he had chosen. They performed God's sign among them and his wonders in the land of Ham. Our response, "The Lord remembers his covenant forever." Kindly stand for the gospel. Alleluia, alleluia. Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus declared, "Come to me, all you who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The words of today's Gospel: take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and lowly in heart, are really very consoling. Jesus says, come to me, all you who labor, heavy laden, I will give you rest. Very short gospel, but consoling. And these are words Jesus said to the people, said to his apostles, to his disciples, and he says it to us. We are invited to a friendship with Jesus, invited to a companionship with Jesus, invited to know him. Regretfully, we can't receive, most of us can't receive Holy Communion physically, but we make a spiritual communion, ask him to come into our hearts, prepare ourselves for the day when we will receive him. But listening to his word, we know his mind and feel this deep love. And Christianity is a religion of love. Love is the priority in everything. And we begin by having love for Jesus. Let's ask Jesus to help us to know to love him even more. The first reading is from Exodus. We continue the story of Moses. Moses was, told you about how he was rescued, and now we want God to says, go and liberate my people are suffering. And here we have the whole narrative again, where God is telling him that I have heard the voice of my people, the cry of my people whom I have chosen. They are suffering, and now you've got to take them into freedom. Moses makes all sorts of excuses. He says, they'll ask me, what's your name? Who are this? He says, I am who I am. Again, theologically, it means I am the eternal one. I always am. There's no I will be, I was, I am. That's what all the theologians interpret I am to be. Then again, Moses says, but he may not listen to me. And then God says, but I will make sure he listens to you. I will be there with a strong hand. And then he says again, I'm a poor speaker. I can't speak well. And probably Moses had a stammer, some people say. But God says, I will tell you what to say, and I will put the words in your mouth. And so finally, Moses tells the Lord, he says, find somebody else. Can't you find somebody else? But God had chosen him for this task. And it's so we see Moses' diffidence, his humility, but also his fear. He never thought that he was a leader, naturally born leader, but was frightened of such a great task to go and confront the king himself and to lead all the people out. But we will continue to hear. This is Exodus. You find what we heard in our catechism classes, we see here now in scripture, and the message is God is with the chosen people. God is with us. If God is with us, no one can be against us. Today is the feast of Saint Bonaventure, the second founder of the Franciscans, and he was a colleague of Thomas Aquinas. They say Tantum Ergo was composed by Thomas Aquinas, and they had both gone to the Pope. The Pope had asked him to compose some hymns, and when Bonaventure was so humble, he heard Thomas's composition. He was one who said first that Bonaventure just tore what he wrote, and so we lost some treasures which we would have probably had. Some must have been very brilliant hymns. Bonaventure was born, and when he was small, just 4 years old, he had some serious illness. His mother took him to Francis of Assisi, Francis prayed over the child. He was baptized John, his name was John. Francis prayed over the child, knelt down, and then he blessed the child. And they say the child was cured instantly, Bonaventure. And so then Francis said, many good things to come, which means Bonaventura in Latin. So good things to come, that's how his name Bonaventure. And his mother since then called him Bonaventure, because that's what Bonaventura, that's what Francis of Assisi called him, and he cured him. Then she sent him to study philosophy, theology in Paris, where he met Thomas Aquinas, And his mother told him that, you know, when you were sick, very sick, I took you to Francis, I made a vow that I would give you to the church. And that's, Bonaventure also felt inspired to follow Jesus, and he joined the Franciscans. He soon became a good preacher, good lecturer, and later on became even the general at a young age. And he was a good administrator, they said, because there was lots of confusion and division. St. Francis of Assisi was very charismatic, but he could not hold the group together because he was not a very good administrator. And so much so that they wanted to throw him out of the Franciscans at one stage. But Bonaventure was able to form the statutes, form the law, and was able, very peaceful man, even in difficulties, they say, he wasn't ruffled, was able to get the groups together. And so that's why they call him second founder. And there was peace in the Franciscans again. The Pope insisted, once one Pope appointed him Bishop of York, he didn't accept. And finally, Pope Gregory insisted he takes over, because there was going to be a Vatican Council, not Vatican, Ecumenical Council, Council at Lyons in France. And then, where they were, the Greeks had separated, the Pope wanted to join them together. So he wanted the help of Bonaventure for this council. So he made him Bishop Albano, a place very close to Rome. I think where Castel Gandolfo is, Albano Diocese. And then he made him a cardinal and got him to guide the council. He guided the council. There was unity. Those groups that separated joined again. He was a very big reconciler. And but he got sick immediately after that and died during the council itself. They say all the bishops were there for the council, went for his funeral. And he was named Doctor of the Church and canonized by the Pope. Man known for his holiness. They say that his head was incorrupt when they exhumed the body. They mentioned about him, it's interesting, we are in a pandemic. There was a plague or some illness in Lyons, and they took his relics in that city, and the plague went off. So let's pray to Bonaventure, Saint Bonaventure, to help us, you and me, also this pandemic, so that we come out of it and come back to spreading God's word. God bless you. Happy feast to the Bonaventures. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Your goodness with this bread which we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Your goodness from this wine which we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, our Father in heaven.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the sacrifice which we gladly present on the feast day of blessed Bonaventure be pleasing to you, O God. For taught by him, we too give ourselves entirely to you in praise. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new, and offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled, their great example gives us courage. Their fervent prayers sustain us in all we do. So, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, and exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, me, your unworthy servant, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Bonaventure, with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be cursed to eternal life, praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, to you, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, be all glory and honor forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence the Father in the words Jesus gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we be always free from sin, safe from all distress. We wait the blessed hope and coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Offer the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
We now make our spiritual communion with the Lord. O Lord Jesus, since I cannot now receive you in your sacramental presence, I beg you to come spiritually into my soul, to enrich me with your holy grace, and make me truly your own forever. O Jesus, living in Mary, come and live in me, in the spirit of your holiness, in the fullness of your power, in the communion of your mysteries, in the perfection of your ways. O divine guest, give to my soul a strong, lively faith, an unbounded trust, perfect humility, an abiding sorrow for my sins, a total abandonment to your divine will, and a perfect loving union with you in mind and heart. O Sacrament most holy, O Sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment thine. Lord Jesus, thank you for the blessings and graces you have given me through this spiritual communion.
Let us pray. Through Christ, the teacher, O Lord, instruct those you feed with Christ, the living bread. On the feast day of the Blessed Bonaventure, may they learn your truth and express it in works of charity. Make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Your mighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass ended. Let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Once again, happy feast to any Bonaventures here. God bless each one of you. Keep you safely. Tomorrow we'll have, again, I won't be there, Friday, Father Joseph David, who is now also newly ordained, and he'll be saying Mass now from Immaculate Conception Church, Borivali. And then this evening, the catechesis, we are repeating a question which you might have been in your mind. It was about vaccines. Father Stephen Fernandez, moral theologian, will speak about that. God bless you. Have a lovely evening and see you on Saturday. God bless.
Prayer for relief from the coronavirus. Almighty and merciful God, who show your love to all creation everywhere, hear graciously the prayers we make for all those affected by the coronavirus in various parts of the world. We come before you asking for an efficacious control of the outbreak, for a healing of those affected, for the victims and their families. We thank you for blessing the efforts of our research scientists working on the development of a vaccine. We pray that these vaccines will be effective in combating the virus and its mutants and in controlling the spread of the pandemic and be available to all. We pray for doctors, nurses, and health workers who are in the front line of this battle, that they be kept safe and have the strength and courage to continue their heroic efforts. We pray for the government and health authorities that they take appropriate steps for the good of the people. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Cast your burden unto Jesus, for he died to set us free. Only trust him, he will triumph, yours will be the victory. Vast his mercy, like the ocean, and his love is as the flood. shed his precious blood. Cast your burden onto Jesus, for he died to set us free. Only trust him, he will triumph, yours will be the victory. Grace and pardon, mighty rivers, poured incessant from above. Like a river, peace and justice, peace the guilty one with love. Cast your burden onto Jesus, for he died to set us free. Only trust him, he will triumph, yours will be the victory.